In the process of light reaction, as we have seen that the ATP and NADPH are being generated inside the thylakoid. Now this ATP and NADPH will now come out of the thylakoid and will be directly utilized in the stroma in a cyclic biochemical reaction, which is called the Kelvin-Benson cycle. And it is this Kelvin-Benson cycle which is also goes by the name of the dark reaction, just as the previous process is called the light reaction. So this dark reaction process, which is also like in reality it is a light independent process, is actually the place where the carbon dioxide is being fixed and ultimately the sugar molecule is being formed. So let's learn about the process that actually takes place in this step. So the entire process, as it was mentioned before, it is a cyclic process. Means here we do get the same, like one of the reagent or one of the reactant of this particular process, it actually reform itself, it recycle itself through the entire course of the process. So that's why this step is called the cyclic. It's considered as a cyclic step. Now in this process, the main thing is the fixation of the carbon. The very first step is the fixation of the carbon, or in the form of carbon dioxide. So what happens is, like the CO2 that was absorbed by the plant will be now utilized or will be fixed by this enzyme called Rubisco. The name written there is Rubisco. The full form of it is ribulose bisphosphate carboxylase oxygenase. Now this particular enzyme is responsible for fixation of the carbon dioxide. It is a most abundant, one of the most abundant enzyme that is found in the living world. So this Rubisco enzyme, it is going to fix the carbon dioxide with the ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate molecule, which is the reactant here, and will form first of all, it will form an intermediate. The very first thing, the intermediate is just a combination. See, the ribulose bisphosphate is a 5 carbon structure. So this 5 carbon structure, it is going to combine with the carbon dioxide and form a 6 carbon molecule. It's an intermediate, but the intermediate is a unstable one, and it itself just breaks itself down to this 3-phosphoglyceric acid. This molecule is actually the first product, or the first product that we get, stable product that we get in the process of the photosynthesis, first stable product in the process of Kelvin-Benson cycle also. So this stable product sometimes is actually because of this presence of this, or this production of this stable product, we actually name this process as the C3 cycle also. There are other types of molecules that are also formed, so we'll come to that later on. So this molecule, the C3 molecule, means 3 carbon structure, is actually the first stable compound that we actually get. Now after that, this entire thing will enter the process of the chemical reshuffling, where the first ATP molecule will be used. So ATP is going to be added with the 3-phosphoglyceric acid, forming 3-phosphoglycerate, phosphoglycerate. Now from that, actually, I'm repeating the same thing. Actually, it's going to form 1,3,3 bisphosphoglycerate, which is like 2-phosphate molecule adhered to both the side. You can see the molecular arrangement is shown there. Okay, so we are going to get this 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate inside the plant. We will observe that it's actually being produced as a second molecule. Now this is the intermediate, but a stable one. Now this 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate is going to get converted into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, means a reduction is taking place. And that reduction step will require the NADPH to donate the hydrogen here. Now NADPH and ATP is actually used in these two steps, as you can notice here. And you have already studied that these two things are coming from the thylakoid, isn't it? Means the light reaction. So it is dependent on the light reaction. The entire process is dependent on the light reaction. Now once this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is generated, now We have to keep in mind there is actually one more additional point to be mentioned here is that it's the entire process is not taking place as a one molecule step, but rather three molecules of RuBP is getting converted into six molecules of 3PG, means the phosphoglyceric acid, and then that converts into similarly six molecules of bisphosphoglycerate, and then finally six molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, or PGALD, sometimes it is being mentioned also. So once this 3-PGALD is being formed, or G3P molecule is being formed, one of them is going to get converted into like the sugar, okay, and the rest of the five will actually enter into the in the process of reformation of the RuBP molecule. Means six molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is being produced. One of that molecule is actually going to get converted into the sugar molecule. We can say that every single sugar molecule that we get from the plant, it's not necessarily that from the plant we are going to get only and only the glucose as the only product, but in reality, every single kind of sugar molecule, it is possible. Even disaccharide, trisaccharide, all kinds of molecules are possible. But to make that possible, the very first thing that is required is this 3-carbon sugar. And this is actually a 3-carbon sugar molecule, this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is the first thing that will be formed. Then as many as required. This, like for the process of making one sugar, glucose, we require two glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So that means two times this entire thing will actually take place. Like here it is shown like three molecules or six molecules like that, isn't it? So six out of the six, one is entering this process. That means two times if this process continue, then we get two glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, and then two glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is going to get converted into one glucose. It can also get converted into one fructose, or they may be joined together to form one sucrose, or likewise as many different kinds of sugar as required, but that completely depend on the plant itself, like the whichever type of the sugar the plant is going to make. Now once this is done, that remainder of the remaining was five molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate will now enter into the as I said, it's a reformation step. So it's getting back whatever RuBP was getting converted into all these different things. So it is actually the RuBP which is it is formed. So right there again another molecule of the ATP will be used, which will donate its phosphate, and then we will find that the ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate molecule is being formed. Means this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate molecule itself is going to get converted into ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate. So that is how the entire process of the Kelvin cycle is it gets carried out. And let me tell you something, this is not a detailed representation, as because the detailed representation is not in the within the scope of your syllabus. So that's why this entire thing is given in this abbreviated form, and this is the abbreviated form definitely you are going to study for the level of the of your standard. This is the level, this is the thing that you are going to study. In higher classes, like in graduation, post-graduation, every single intermediate steps and every single thing is being taught there, right? So, I can tell you just one thing, that this production of this conversion of the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to the sugar, means the desired sugar, it actually is actually the reverse step of glycolysis, the process which you are going to learn in the chapter of respiration next. So you can say that when you learn about the respiration, that time you learn at least the reverse step of how this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is getting converted into the sugar. So that time you'll know a little bit of those intermediate steps that are there, because it is mentioned here in one single step that actually occurs in multiple steps. So yes, this is the process of Kelvin cycle, or this also goes by the name of C3 cycle, and this takes place within the stroma of the chloroplast.